a favorite of mine because it allows me to express how much I really love you, Lord. I love you because your love never changes for me. Your love doesn't depend on my actions. It's not indifferent. It's patient. It's kind. Man, your love is ever consistent in my life. That's why I love you.
Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, fulfillment, and tell him how much you really love him.
Oh God, we just want to bless you tonight, Father God. We want to glorify you, Lord. Lift you up and praise your name, Father God. We want to give you everything that's due unto you on tonight, Father God, because you're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, Father God. And you're greater to be praised, Lord. So on tonight, Father God, we want to give you everything that's required of us, Lord God. Everything that's within us, Lord God, because it's due unto you, Father God. We want to give it to you on tonight, Lord God. We want to come before you on tonight, Lord God. We want to give you our best on tonight, Father God, because you do so much for us, Lord God. We want to let you know how much we appreciate you, Father God. We want to tell you thank you, Father God. We want to outpour our heart of gratitude and appreciation, Father God, because if it had not been for you, Lord God, we would not be where we are right now on today, Lord God. So, Father God, we just want to tell you thank you on tonight, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Father God, for all that you have done for us the more, Lord God. We appreciate you, Father God, just for being who you are within our life, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, God. So right now, dear Heavenly Father, as we open up our hearts to give you thanks and praise on tonight, Lord God. We want to outpour ourselves to you totally and completely, Lord God, to give you everything that we may carry, Father God, knowingly and unknowingly, Father God. We want to give you every problem, worry, and concern, Father God, every situation and circumstance, Lord God, whether it be for ourselves or someone else, God. We want to give you all those things that we may carry, Father God, those things, Father God, that may cause us to be heavy weighted in our hearts, God, those things that may cause us to have a strain on our brain, Lord God. We want to give you all those things, Lord God, because we want to make more room for you to enter in, Lord God. We do not want to be all cluttered up, Father God. We do not want to be distracted, Father God, or worry about the cares and the worries of this life, Lord God, because we know, Father God, you are bigger than all these things, Lord God. You know how to handle it all, Father God. You know just what to do with these things, Lord God. So we give it all to you on tonight, Father God. We give you those things that be going on in our homes, God. We give you those things that be going on within our hearts, God. We give you all those things that we may carry inside of our minds, Father God, that we be going on and cause strain in our brain within our families on tonight, Lord God. We give it all to you on tonight, Father God, totally and complete, Lord God. We just give you all our bags on tonight, Father God, that we can make more room for you, Lord God. So right now, we open up our hearts, God, and we pour out our hearts to you on tonight, Lord God. Everything that may be heavy on us on tonight, Lord God, those things that we cannot figure out what to do about, God, we're coming to you and we're giving it to you, Lord God, because you are the one who gives us instruction, God. You are the one who gives us direction, God. So we outpour it all to you on tonight, Father God, because we know, Lord God, you're bigger than all these things, Lord God. We give it all to you on tonight because you know how to handle it, Lord God. You said, Father God, we keep our hearts and our minds stay on you, God, and we're keeping you, you keep us in perfect peace, Lord God. So on tonight, Lord God, as we outpour these things, we posture our hearts and our minds towards you, God, that you may keep us in perfect peace, Lord God. We outpour all these things to you on tonight, Lord God, because we want you to come in and have your way, Lord God. So right now, Father God, we open up our hearts that you may come in and have your way, God. We welcome you on tonight, Father God. We welcome you into our hearts, God. We welcome you to our minds, God. We welcome you into our situation, circumstances, Lord God. No matter what it is, God, we welcome you in the midst of it, Lord God, because we know, Father God, you can handle all these things, Lord God. You are the one, Father God, who has all power in your hand, Lord God. You are the great creator, Lord God. So you are the one, Father God, who's in control of everything that has gone on within our life, Father God. Whether it has happened or it's happening now, God, you are the one, Father God, who allowed that thing, Lord God. So on tonight, Lord God, we open up our hearts to you, God, that you may give us a heart of acceptance, Lord God, that you may give us a heart of truth on tonight, Father God, that we accept everything, Father God, that you bring to us on tonight, Father God. No matter what you say, Lord God, no matter what you show us, God, we're going to accept these things, Lord God, because we know, Father God, you have our best interests at hand, Lord God. You know what's best for us, Lord God. So we open up our hearts that we may receive the more of you, God. Oh God, we just welcome you on tonight, Father God. We embrace the more of you on tonight, Father God, because we need you, Father God. We need you on tonight, Father God, in more ways than one, Lord God. We need you, Father God, to be our comforter, Lord God. We need you, Father God, to be our provider, Lord God. We need you on tonight, Father God, to be our way maker, Lord God. We need you on tonight, Father God, to be our instructor on tonight, Lord God. So right now, Father God, we just open up our hearts to make more room for you to enter, Lord God, that you may come in and have your way, Lord God. Instruct us, lead, Father God, lead us and guide us, Father God. Order our footsteps and direct our path, Father God. Show us the way, Lord God, because you know the way, Lord God. You are the great God. You are Alpha and Omega, Father God. You are our King, Lord God, and you know everything, Lord God. So whatever it is on tonight, Father God, that you need us to accept and open up our hearts to God, we open up our hearts to accept and receive that thing, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we just want to tell you thank you on tonight, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Father God. Oh, God, we just come to you right now, Father God. We present our hearts to you on tonight, Lord God. That our hearts, Father God, would be open, that you may do some things on tonight, Father God. That you may move some things out the way, Lord God. Any and everything that's not like you, Father God, we ask that you would take it all the way, Lord, until there's nothing left but you, God. Oh, God, we come before you on tonight, Lord God, that you may lead us by your Spirit, Lord God. Decrease us, Father God, that you may increase, Father God. Place those things in our heart and our mind, Father God, that you want us to ponder on, Lord God. Place those things on our hearts and our mind, Father God, that you want us to confess and release on tonight, Lord God. Place those things on our hearts and our mind, Father God, that you need for us, Father God, to be focused on, Lord God, because you know what's best for us, Lord God. So right now, Father God, we open up our hearts and we welcome you on tonight, God. We welcome you, we welcome you, we welcome you on tonight, Father God, because we need you to be in our midst, God. We need you to be in our presence, God. We need you, Father God, to be in our situations, Lord God, because we don't know what to do or how to do or even when to do, God. But you do, Father God. So on tonight, Lord God, we open up and we embrace the more of you, Lord God. Oh, Father God, I ask on tonight, Lord God, you will saturate the atmosphere, Father God, that you, Father God, will consume us with your Spirit on tonight, Lord God. That we, Father God, may be led by your Spirit, Lord God. Oh, God, I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, that you will place my heart and your heart on one accord, Father God. That my thoughts and your thoughts be intertwined, Father God. That I will only pray what you will have me to pray, Father God. That I will only speak what you will have me to speak, Father God. That I will not add to, take away, compromise, or pervert your word, Lord God. But that you will use me as a vessel on tonight, Father God. As a voice on tonight, Lord God. Because, Father God, it's nothing that I am doing, God. It's all because of you, Lord God. And I don't know what your people need, Father God. But you do, Father God. So I come before you right now, Father God, and present myself, Father God, as a living sacrifice, Father God. I come before you on tonight, Lord God, that you may be the Spirit, Father God, that dwells inside of this temple, Lord God. And if there's any unclean things on the inside of me, Lord God, if my heart, Father God, is not partial right towards you, Lord God, I'm asking, Father God, that you will clean it up, Lord God. Help me to recognize and see it, Father God, that I may be in right standing with you, Lord God. Right now, Father God, I'm emptying out myself to you on tonight, Father God, that I may be led by your Spirit on tonight, Lord God. Oh, Father God, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, I thank you, I thank you, I thank you on tonight, Father God, for all that you have done for me and more, Lord God. I thank you on tonight, Father God, for everything that you are doing now, Father God, everything that you're about to, Lord God, even on the behalf of my loved ones, Lord, I thank you, God. I thank you, I thank you on tonight, Father God. Oh, God, we just open up our hearts to you on tonight, Father God, because we need you to move us by your Spirit, Lord God. We need you, Father God, to wrap your arms around us and comfort us on tonight, Lord God, because some of us are comfortless, Lord God. Some of us are in a place of sadness and depression, Lord God, and some of us, Father God, are in a place of being lost because we don't have direction, God. But we know, Father God, you are our great shepherd, Lord God, and that we are your sheep, Lord God, and we'll listen for the sound of your voice, Lord God. So let's be in tune with your Spirit on tonight, Father God. Uncork our ears, Father God. Remove the scales of our eyes, Lord God, and declutter our brains, Lord God, that we'll think of those things that are of you on tonight, Lord God. That you may show us what to do, God. Instruct us on tonight, Father God. Step by step, Father God. Moment by moment, Father God. Lead your people on tonight, Father God, because we need you, Lord God. We do not know how to complete this journey in life, Father God, without you, Lord God. And we open up our hearts that you may come in, Father God, and drink us on tonight, Lord God. We open up our hearts on tonight, Father God, that you may give us that unction in our spirit that we need, Father God, that we'll know which way to go, Lord God. Oh, God, we thank you on tonight, Father God, because we could not make it this far in life without you, Father God. You are our great protector, Lord God. You are the one, Father God, who went before us and made the way, Lord God. You kept us safe each and every step of the way, God. We just want to take a thank you, Father God, because if it had not been for you, Lord, we don't know where we would be, Lord God. Oh, God, we thank you on tonight, Father God, for all that you have done for us, some more, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for the clothes on our back, the shoes on our feet, and the food on our table, Lord God, for the transportation that you provide for us, Father God. And even if we don't have our own transportation, God, we thank you, Lord God, that you allow someone, Father God, to give us a ride, Lord God, or that we have public transportation, Lord God, that you provide a way, Father God, out of no way for us to get back and forth where we needed to go, Lord. We want to say you thank you, Father God. We thank you on tonight, Father God, that you kept us all through the day, Lord God, that you kept us, Father God, safe and sound. And when we had travels, Lord God, you gave us safe travels, Lord. And we want to tell you thank you for that, Lord God. Oh God, we thank you for all that you have done for us, the more, Lord God. If it had not been for you, God, being our great provider, Lord God, for being our soul source, our way maker, Lord God, we would not have these things that we have, Lord God. And we thank you for everything that you have allowed us to obtain, Lord God, for us to be able, Father God, to sustain our day-to-day living, Lord God. Oh Lord, we just want to tell you thank you for it all, God. We are so grateful, Father God, for all that you have done for us, the more, Lord God. So we come before you, Father God, to give you a heart of praise and thanksgiving on tonight, Lord God. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Lord God. And as we present our hearts to you on tonight, Lord God, we're asking that you would come in, Father God, and that you would continue to purify our hearts, Lord God, as you continue to cleanse us, Lord God, and make us whole and complete and you want tonight, Father God, that you would come in, Father God, and tear down all the walls, Lord God, that you remove any anger, Father God, any bitterness, Father God, any regrets, Father God, that you, Father God, would take away any resentment on tonight, Father God. Oh God, touch us on tonight, Lord God, and tear down all the walls, Father God, of those things that happen within our life, Lord God, that we had no control over, Lord God, that we, Father God, would not hold these things inside of our hearts, God, but we'll let them go, Father God, that we continue, Father God, to allow the past to be the past, Lord God, because we can't change it, Lord God, we can't get a do-over, Lord God, and we sure enough, Father God, can't do anything about it because that day is already gone, Lord God. So touch your people on tonight, Lord God, they'll continue to move forward, Lord God, and look up, Father God, let their eyes, Father God, be focused on you, Lord God, and what you have in store for them on tonight, Lord God. Oh God, touch your people on tonight, Lord God, and tear down all the walls in the light on their lives on today, Father God. Every barrier, Father God, every shackle and every chain, Lord God, all the things, Father God, that cause your people to feel defeated, Lord God, let them know their self-worth and their value on today, Lord God, let them know there's somebody in you on tonight, Lord God. Oh God, touch your people on tonight, Father God, because so many of your people need you, Father God, in more ways than one, Father God, in some form, shape, or fashion, God, we all need you, God, and we welcome you in on tonight, Father God, that you may tear down the walls, Lord God, that we may be able to see afar, Lord God, that we will not even build up walls, Father God, to protect our own soul, Lord God. You are the one, Father God, who's our protector, Lord God, and we invite you in, Lord God, because we know, Lord God, that you will not allow anything to happen to us, Lord God. And whatever you do allow, Father God, is for our best intentions, Lord God. You know what's best for us, Lord God. Whatever that you do allow, Father God, it was needed, it was necessary, Father God. Everything that occurs within our life, Father God, is for a lesson and for our teaching, Lord God. And we want to tell you thank you, Father God, for every lesson, Lord God, for every trial and every test, Father God, for every challenge that you have helped us to face, Lord God, every mountain that you help us to climb, Father God, everything that you have allowed us to overcome, Lord God. Oh God, we want to tell you thank you on tonight, Father God, because there's nothing that we were able to do on our own, God. It was all because of you, Lord. We want to tell you thank you, Father God. We want to ask right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you would touch your people on tonight, Lord God, that you would help them, Father God, to break away from those things that need to break away from, Father God. Any addictions, Lord God. Any people, Lord God. Any things on today, Father God. I'm asking that you would sever any old ties and any soul ties. I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, you even remove any people, Father God, that are not meant to be in the lives of your people on today, Father God, that's causing them to be hindered, Lord God. That's causing them, Father God, not to be able to do what you have called for them to do on today, Lord God. Oh God, I'm just asking that you touch your people on tonight, Father God, and that you would deliver your people, Lord God, because so many of your people, Father God, need to be delivered, Father God, from something, Lord God, whether it be a habit, Lord God, whether it be a way of thinking on today, Father God. Whatever it is, God, I'm asking that you would make and set your people free on tonight, Lord God. Oh God, touch them on tonight, Lord God, give them a heart of acceptance, God, they have a heart of truth, Lord God, because it's the only way your people, Father God, will be able to be freed on tonight, Lord God. So let your people accept the truth on tonight, Father God, whatever it is pertaining to or concerning, Lord God. Let your people accept the truth on tonight, Father God, that they're not leaning to their own understanding, Father God. They're not looking at a thing or even allow things to be heard, Father God, to cause them to be deceived, Father God, or manipulated in their mind, Father God, or even lie to them own selves on today, Father God. Oh God, touch your people on tonight, Father God, and make them free, Lord God, because you are the only one who can make us free on tonight, God, because you, Father God, are the truth, Father God, the way and the life on today, Lord God. So I ask that your people, Father God, will be able to see the light on today, Lord God, and the people, Father God, will be able to see their way on today, Father God, and they will accept these truths, Father God, that we are not being in denial about these things, Lord God, but we accept the truth of the matter about the whole situation, Lord God, that we are not justified, Father God, we will not make excuses on tonight, Father God, or any justification, Lord God, but we will simply accept that thing just for what it is, God, and that we will not even lie to our own selves, Lord. Oh God, we ask right now in the name of Jesus, God, you continue to pull these things up from out of our hearts to the surface, Lord God, that we can be free in our hearts, God, that we can be free from that thing that causes bondage in our emotions, Lord God, that we can be free from that thing that causes to be bound, Father God, in our minds, God. Oh God, touch your people on tonight, God, and make them free, Lord God. Touch your people free, Father God, across this entire nation, Lord God. There's so many people, Father God, are held captive in their minds, God. There's so many people, Father God, who are held captive, Father God, in the situations in their homes, God. But I'm gonna ask you right now, in the name of Jesus, God, you would touch them on tonight, Father God, their chain will be broken, Lord God. They will be loose from that thing on today, Father God. Whatever it is that's caused your people, Father God, to be heavy weighted, Lord God, and not being able to be set free, God, I'm asking that you will make them free, God. Because when you set them free, Father God, they'll be free, Lord God. Oh, God, I just want to take a thank you, Lord God. We thank you on tonight, Father God, because you are the only way, Father God, that we can be free, Lord God. So, God, I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, that you would touch your people and order their footsteps and direct their path, Father God. Lead them, guide them, and show them the way on tonight, Father God. Touch your people on tonight, Father God, and regulate their thoughts, regulate their minds, God. They may have the right thinking on tonight, Lord God. Touch your people on tonight, Father God, and touch their hearts, Lord God. They will have the right love in their hearts, God. Touch all of us on tonight, Lord God, because we all, Father God, want to have our hearts, Father God, in the right place, especially as it being postured towards you on tonight, Lord God. So help us to recognize and see these things, Lord God, because we cannot see it on our own, God. We need your help, Father God. Oh, God, I'm just asking that you would touch on tonight, Father God. Let your touch, Father God, move some things, God. Let your touch on tonight, Father God, change some things, God. Let your touch on tonight, Father God, rearrange some things, Lord God, because I know, Father God, you can, Lord God. I know that you will, Father God. You're more than able, God, because you are the only one, Father God, who has the power to do so, God. So, God, I'm asking that your people, Father God, would know who you are within their life, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, that nothing happened by chance, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, that you are the one who preordained and predestined thing, Lord God, that you are a God who makes no mistakes, God. So let them accept everything that's going on within their life, Father God, no matter how it happens, Lord God. You are the one who's in control of it all, God. You are the one who holds all power in your hand, Lord God. You are the God, Father God, who sits on the throne in heaven, Father God, use the earth as your footstool, Lord God, and that makes you a great big old God, Lord God. So on tonight, Father God, we acknowledge you, Father God, for being the God that you are, Lord God. You are not the universe, Lord God. You are not the stuff, Lord God. You're not look, Father God. You're not magic, Father God. But you are God. You are a spirit, and you are a great big old God. And even though we cannot see you, God, we can feel you, Lord God. So God, I'm asking that you'll let your people feel you on tonight, Lord God, that know that you are real, Lord God. I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, that you will show yourself mighty and strong within your lives of your people, God. They will know without a shout of a doubt, Father God, that you are the one who did it, Lord God. Oh God, we thank you for everything that you do for us, Lord God. We thank you, Father God. Lord, you do so much for us, God. We just want to tell you how much we appreciate you, God, how much you mean to us, Lord God, because without you in our lives, we will not be here today, Lord God. You are the one who breathed breath within our body, Father God. You are the one who called us by name, Lord God. You are the one, Father God, who handpicked and chose us, Lord God, for the very thing that we are going through right now, Father God, because you knew that we can handle that thing, Lord God. You said that you are not, Father God, give us more than we can handle, Lord God, more than we can bear, Lord God. So let your people know, Father God, whatever it is they're going through right now, Father God, whatever their situation or circumstance is, God, that you are the one, Father God, who placed that thing in their path, because you needed them to be stricken, Lord God. You needed to mold them and shape them, Father God, for whatever it is that you have preordained and predestined for them to walk through in their life, Lord God. So, God, I'm asking right now as you continue to hold the hand of your people, Lord God, as you continue to take them throughout this journey in life, Lord God. I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, you continue to equip your people, Lord God. Let them continue, Father God, to use the tools in the toolbox that you have given us, Lord God, to continue to fight this good fight and complete this journey, Lord God. I'm asking right now, Father God, if your people are not equipped, Lord God, that you allow them to cross paths with someone, Father God, they may be able to be equipped, Lord God. That they may be able to learn what it is they need to do, Father God, to face this challenge, Lord God, to walk this walk, Lord God. To take this journey on today, Father God. Let them know, Father God, this thing will not overtake them, God. Let them know on tonight, Father God, they will not be overwhelmed, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, they are mighty and strong in you on tonight, God. So, God, strengthen your people on today, Father God. They may continue to endure, Father God. They may continue to press, Lord God. They may continue to be encouraged, Lord God, and not get weary in their well-doing, God. Oh, God, I'm asking that you touch your people on tonight, Father God, continue to help them to fight this good fight, Lord God, because we cannot do it without you, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we just want to take a thank you on tonight, God. We thank you. Thank you on tonight, Father God, because if it had not been for you, Lord, we don't know where we would be, God, and we bless you, Lord God. Oh, God, we want to give you all the praise and glory on tonight, Father God. It's due unto you, God, because you are worthy, Lord. You're worthy, Father God, and you're greatly to be praised, God. We want to bless you, God. We bless you, Lord God. Oh, God, we just want to continue to invite you in on tonight, Father God, into our homes, God, into our hearts, God, into our marriages, God, into our relationships, God, into our situations and circumstances, Lord God, that you will take everything away, Father God, that is not of you, Lord God, into all that is left is that is of you, Lord God. So let your spirit move on tonight, Father God. Consume us, Lord God. Let us know that you are here, Father God. Lord, you said whether two or three gather, that you will be in the midst, God. So God, I'm asking that you will be in our midst on tonight, Father God, that you will saturate the atmosphere heavily on tonight, Father God, because we need your presence on tonight, Father God. We need to be guided by your spirit on tonight, Father God, because you are the one, Father God, who gives us direction and instruction, Lord God. You are the one who's the pilot, Father God, that's guiding this plane on tonight, Father God. You are the one, Father God, who handcrafted everything that's going on within our life, Father God. You are the author and the finisher, Lord God. So Lord God, as you continue, Father God, to write our story, Lord God, as you continue to connect the puzzle pieces, Lord God, I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, you continue to give us the heart of acceptance, Lord God. Because everything that you have done and allowed, Father God, it was necessary, Lord God. It was needed, Father God. And we want to continue to stay the course, Lord God. So, God, I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, you continue, Father God, let your people be fully armored on, Lord God. They will continue to watch as well as pray, Lord God. They will continue to stand on guard and stand on post, Lord God, not giving the enemy any room to enter in, Lord God. Oh, God, I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, you will seal up every crack and every crevice, Lord God. I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, you continue to keep us in tune with the Spirit, Lord God, that we can see the device that the enemy tries to bring on today, Lord God. I'm asking right now in the name of Jesus, God, you continue to keep our spiritual and talents, Father God, in tune with heaven, Lord God, that we continue to be led by your Spirit, Lord. Oh God, we thank you for the guiding of your Spirit on tonight, Lord God, because we could not get throughout this journey in life without you, Lord God. And we are so grateful for you, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for that connection that you give us with you, Lord God. We thank you for that one-on-one intimacy, God, that you are building with us, with you on tonight, Lord. We thank you, Father God, because that's truly, Father God, something that we cherish, Lord God, and we don't want to be without it, Lord God. So we thank you, Father God, for the guidance of your Spirit, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for allowing us to commune with you, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for giving us access, Father God, to come to you in prayer, Lord God, individual, Lord God, that we don't have to come through anybody else, God, but we can come to you our own selves, God. So, Lord, I'm asking on tonight, Lord God, that you will hear your people's hearts cry on tonight, Lord God. There's some things that your people have prayed for, Father God, they have not told anybody else, Lord God. There's some things your people have spoken, Lord God, and they're still waiting for you to do, Lord God. And I'm asking on tonight, Lord God, that you, Father God, will hear and consider the prayers on tonight, Father God, of all your people, Lord God. I'm asking, Lord God, that you even hear the prayers, Father God, and the tears that your people cry, Lord God, because sometimes your people don't even know what to pray for, Father God. They don't even know what they need, God. But you know the need, Father God. You know how it needs to be met, Lord God. You don't even know when it needs to be met, Lord God. So on tonight, Lord God, I'm going to ask that you will meet the needs of your people, Father God, across this entire nation, Father God, north, south, east, and west, Father God. Every man, every woman, every child, every boy, Father God. Every race, God, every religion, every ethnic group, Lord God. I'm going to ask that you will touch them all on tonight, Father God. Touch them from top to the head, Lord God, to the crowns of their feet, Lord God. Touch their hearts, their minds, their bodies, their souls, and their spirits, Lord God. And rearrange some things on tonight, Lord God. Because there's some things in the lives of people that need to be arranged, Lord God. Oh God, touch your people on tonight, Lord God, and continue to let them know who they are and you on today, Father God. Let your people, Father God, not have an identity crisis, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, just who it is that you have handcrafted for them to be, Lord God. And let them know, Father God, that everything that you make, Father God, is wonderful and it is good, Lord God. So touch your people on tonight, Father God, in a mighty way, Lord God. Touch your people on tonight, Father God, and let your spirit flow, Lord God. I'm asking that you continue to touch every hospital, Lord God, every NICU and every ICU, Lord God, every labor and delivery room, Lord God. I'm asking that you would touch on tonight, Father God. I'm asking you touch, Father God, every nursing home, Lord God. I'm asking you touch every foster home and every adoption agency on tonight, Lord God. I'm asking you would touch the homeless on tonight, Father God. Touch the presidency, Lord God. I'm asking you would touch our government leaders on today, Lord God. I'm asking right now, Father God, you would touch the courtroom system on today, Lord God. Touch the judges, Lord God. Touch the lawyers, Lord God. Even touch the jury, Father God, as they sit in, Lord God. Oh God, just touch your people on tonight, Father God, because we need you, God. We need you, we need you, we need you, Father God. And we come to you, Father God, and we confess that we need you, Lord God. We cannot do it on our own, God. We come to you, Father God, and we openly confess, Father God, that we need you, Lord God. We cannot do it on our own, Lord God. So we open up our hearts, Father God, to accept and receive your help, Lord God, because you are our ever-present help in times of need, Lord God. And no matter what it is, God, we know that you'll meet the need, Lord God. So on tonight, Father God, we just uplift you, Father God. We exalt you, Father God. And if by chance, Lord, we have exalted anything higher than you, we're going to pull it down, Father God, because you, Father God, said not to exalt anything higher than you, Lord God. Not no problem, God, not no concern, not no worry, not no ache, no pain, not no sickness, Lord God, because you, Father God, said by Jesus Christ that we are here, Lord God. You are the one, Father God, who told us, Lord God, that all the silver and the gold belong to you. So that means, Father God, that finance is not even a problem, Lord God. No matter what it is, Lord God, we know, God, that you can handle these things, Lord God, and we trust you, God. So touch the hearts and your minds of your people, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, that you are the man of your word and that you are promised people, Lord God. And everything, Father God, you said, it is so, God. So continue to remind your people on tonight, Father God, who you are within their life, Lord God. You are a great big old God, and you don't need nobody's help, Lord God. Everything that you do, Father God, is because of the way that you want to do, Lord God. And we thank you for doing it your way, Lord God, because your way is the best way, God. Your way is the right way, Lord God. We tried it on our own, God, and we failed so many times, God. So once tonight, God, we are ready to accept your will and your way and how you want to do things within our life, Lord God. We conform to your will, God, and we exchange it for ours, Lord God. We put down our will, Lord God. We put down our plan, Lord God, because your plan is the better plan, Lord God. You have the grand master plan, Lord God. And just what you're doing for us, Lord God, we have not even, Father God, imagined the great things that you have in store, Lord God. And we thank you for what you're preparing for us to receive, God. Oh, God, I'm asking that you touch your people on tonight, Father God. Continue to prepare our hearts to accept and receive what you have, Lord God. That we will not misuse or abuse these things, Lord God. Continue to touch our hearts and our minds on tonight, God, that we continue to have a heart an amount of humility on tonight, Father God. That as you do these things in our lives, God, we will not forget about you, Lord God. That we'll continue to acknowledge, Lord God, and give you all the glory, Lord God, because all the glory belongs to you, Lord God. It's nothing that we are doing, God, or obtaining on our own, God. It's all because of you, God. And we give you all the glory and the praise on tonight, God. Oh, Lord, we bless you, Lord. We bless you, we bless you, we bless you, God. So, Lord, on tonight, God, we just continue to surrender all to you, Lord God. Our minds, our body, our hearts, our souls, our spirits, God. Our situations, our circumstances. We give it all to you on tonight, Lord God, because our best is due unto you, Lord God, and all those other things, God, we surrender to you, God, because you said not to worry about these things, Lord God. So we're not going to worry about these things, Lord God. We're going to continue to trust you, Lord God, with what you're doing within our life, Lord God, and allow you to continue to order our footsteps and direct our path, God. And we just want to tell you thank you, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, God. Oh, God, we thank you on tonight, God, because we know that there's no failure in you, God, that you are God of success, Lord God. We thank you on tonight, Father God, for everything that you allow us to be able to obtain, Lord God, the heights that you allow us to reach, God. We just want to tell you thank you on tonight, Lord God, because we could not have done it on our own, God. And we are so grateful, Lord God, that you allowed us to see these things, Father God, in the natural, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Lord. Oh, God, you are so gracious and so merciful, Lord God. And we just want to tell you thank you for your grace and your mercy that you extend upon us each and every day, Lord God. We don't deserve it. We cannot earn it, God, but you give it to us each and every day, God. We thank you for your forgiveness on tonight, Lord God, because, Father God, you are so mindful, so caring, so concerned about us, Lord. And we appreciate you, God, for thinking about us the way that you do, Father God. Being so mindful and concerned about us in each and every way, Lord God. No matter what happens to us, God, even if we stub our toe or get a paper cut, you are concerned, Lord God. And we thank you for being so concerned about us, Lord God. That you made the ultimate sacrifice that you did, Lord God, when you gave your only son who died on the cross for our sins and shed his blood for us, Lord God. Oh, God, we thank you for that, God, because your selfless act of love for us, Lord God, is just unmatched, Lord God. And we know that we cannot find any other love like yours, Lord God. And we thank you for that unconditional love that you have for us, God. Continue to outpour into our hearts each and every day, Lord God, that they love from our hearts, God, will outpour unto others, Lord God, that your love, Father God, will touch this entire nation, Lord God, that we'll continue to come together in unison, Lord God, and build up your kingdom on tonight, Lord God. Oh, God, we just want to tell you thank you tonight, God. We thank you for what you do, how you do it, and when you do it, Lord God, because your timing is perfect and you're always right on time, God. So, Lord, I'm asking us tonight, God, you'll throw your weight around, Lord God, and that you show up, God, when you need to show up, Lord God. Continue to work behind the scenes on the behalf of your people, Lord God. Do what you need to do, Father God. However you need to do it, Lord God, because we know you know what's best for us, God. And we thank you, Lord God. Lord, continue to help your people to fight, Lord God, and not to give up, Lord God. Continue to help your people to fight, Lord God, not to allow that thought in their minds to make them think and believe that they cannot do it, Lord God. Continue to help your people to fight on tonight, Lord God, and not allow what anybody else says, Father God, to keep them from doing what you have called for them to do, Lord God. Oh, God, we just want to say a thank you, Lord God, for helping us to fight, Lord God. Because we know, Lord God, the battle is already won, Lord God. You just need to continue to trust you, Lord God, in what you're doing in our life. And we do trust you, Lord God. We trust you, Father God, with everything and anything within us, Lord God, because you have not let us down, Father God. You have been the same God today. You were the same God yesterday, God. You said you'll say be the same God until the very ends of time, God, that you never change on us, Lord God. And we thank you for being so loyal, so faithful, and true to us, God. We thank you, Lord God. So, Lord, I'm asking right now that you continue to help us to be true to you, Lord God. And be true to ourselves and be true to the other people around us, Lord God. Oh, God, I just want to take a thank you, Lord God, for giving us a spirit of trueness, Lord God, for giving us a spirit of honesty on tonight, Lord God. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Father God. Oh, Lord, you are so amazing, God. You are so wonderful, Father God. There's none other like you, Lord God. You are the greatest in all the land, Lord God. Nobody can compare to who you are within our life, Lord God. We thank you for being the man that we need within our life, Lord God. You provide and meet all of our needs, Lord God. You do everything for us, Lord God. We want to take a thank you, Lord God. We thank you for what you do for us, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, God. Oh, God, we just want to bless you on tonight, Lord God. We just want to give you all the glory and honor on tonight, Father God. We just want to continue to love on you, Father God, because you are so deserving, Father God, of our love, Lord God. You don't ask much of us, Lord God. And the least that we can do, Father God, is express our love to you, God. The least that we can do, Father God, is continue to live our lives the way you have preordained and predestined, Lord God, the way that you have designed for us to live it, Lord God. So help us to do these things, God, because we cannot do it on our own, Lord God. Continue, Lord God, to correct the error in our ways, Lord God. Continue, Lord God, to help us to right our wrongs, Lord God. Continue, Lord God, to help us to be pleasing in your sight, Lord God, because we desire to make you smile, Father God. We want to be able to hear good and well done, my faithful servant, Lord God. We do not want to hear you say, turn away, I know you not, Lord God. So help us on tonight, Father God. Help us to continue to change our attitudes, our way of thinking, Father God, our actions, our reactions, Lord God, that we'll continue to be a reflection in your image, Lord God, because that's the way that you have created us, Lord God, as a reflection of your image, Lord God. to continue to allow us in all our ways to be a reflection of you, Lord God. And we thank you for helping us to do these things, Lord God. Because sometimes it's a challenge for your people, Lord God, to do these things, Lord God. But we know, Father God, that you will not give us a task, Father God, that's too hard to do, Lord God, if you not think we could do it, Lord God. But we know that we are only strengthened through you, Lord God. So strengthen your people on tonight, Father God, in every area of their life, Father God, spiritually as well as naturally, Lord God, emotionally and mentally, Lord God. Strengthen your people on tonight, Father God. Refresh them and revive them, Lord God. Give your people what they need on tonight, Lord God, because you know what's necessary for this journey, God. So continue, Lord God, to equip us, Lord God, to give us that tools that we need, Father God. We continue, Father God, to search your word, Lord God. That we continue to allow that word to be written on the tables of our heart, God, and bound about our neck, Lord God. That we'll take that word with us everywhere that we go, Lord God, because that is one of the important tools that we need to continue this journey, God. So let that word continue to deposit on the inside of us, Lord God. Let us continue, Father God, to grow, flourish, and thrive in you even the more, Lord God. Continue to plant those seeds on the inside of us that you desire to be the Lord God, and everything that's not of you, God, that you don't want to be the God, take it all away, Lord God. Oh, God, we know when you do it, God, you'll leave no residue, Lord God. And that's why we need you to do it, Father God. So help us on tonight, Father God. Help us, Lord God, how you know we need to be helped, Lord God, because we don't know how we need to be helped, God, but you do, Lord God, and we accept the way that you help us on tonight, Lord God. Oh, God, I just want to say you thank you, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, God. Oh, God, we just bless you, Lord. Oh, God, I'm asking you to continue to touch my loved ones on tonight, Father God. You know exactly who they are, God. You know exactly the need, Lord God. You know the very numbers of hairs on their head, God. You know exactly what they're going through, Lord God. You know exactly, Father God, where to meet them at, God. So I'm asking that you will meet them right where they are, Father God. And that you will help them, Father God, to cross that crossroad, Lord God. That you will help them, Father God, to make the choice and decision that they need to make on tonight, Lord God. Oh, God, touch my loved ones on tonight, Father God. Spiritually as well as naturally, Lord God. I'm asking that you will meet them, Father God, in their homes, God, on their jobs, God, wherever that they are, in their cars, God, and meet them and meet the need on tonight, Lord God. Because I know that you're able, Lord God. And I thank you, Father God, for doing it for them, Lord God, for moving on their behalf, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, I thank you, I thank you, God. Lord, continue to touch their hearts, God. They may surrender their hearts to you, Lord God, no matter where they are in their life, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, that nothing that they have done, Lord God, will keep you from loving them, God, because you said that nothing will separate your love from us, God. So, Lord, touch their hearts on tonight, God. They will surrender all to you on tonight, Lord God, that you will be able to take total and complete control of their journey, Lord God. Oh, God, touch on tonight, Father God, in a mighty way, Lord God. Show them the way, Lord God, because they're seeking your direction, God. Their guides, Lord God, and they know, Lord God, that you are the only one who can help them, God. So touch my loved ones on tonight, Lord God, the only way that I know that you can, Lord God, because you did it for me, and I know that you can do it for them, Lord God. So move by your spirit on tonight, Lord God, because you know what's best for us, and we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Lord. Oh, God, I know that you're more than able to help them, Lord. So I just present them and uplift them to you on tonight, Father God, that you may see about them and meet their needs, Lord. And I thank you for doing it for them in advance, God, because I know that you're a miracle worker and that you're a promise keeper, Lord God, and that you are a great big old God and you don't need nobody help when you do it, Lord. So I just thank you for doing it for them, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. Lord, I'm asking on tonight that you continue, Father God, to consider and answer the prayers, Lord God, that you will answer every prayer, Father God, inside of our hearts and our subconscious thinking, Lord God, that you'll let there be no hidden motives, God, no hidden agendas, God, and no hidden intentions, Lord God, but it'll come from the pure sincerity of our hearts, God. As we come to you, Father God, let's come in the right attitude and the right posture, Lord God, because you don't owe us anything, Lord God. So let's be mindful of how we come to you, Lord. And I thank you, Father God, for continuing to consider and answer our prayers, Lord God. And I pray these things, Lord, in your Son Jesus' name, amen.